guns in his hand. In a vert, put a top on that bitch like a hoodie. Doing top speed with my hands on the goodies. Dirty ass boy, where your pop so muddy. Got so much cheese, ain't trust nobody. My man fucked up, can't fuck.
Welcome back to A Trigger Perspectives. We got late night edition. You know what I'm saying? We got a little bloopers, you know, just we finna just crack some jokes.
Late night, real yes, late night combos.
We finna chill, vibe out, you feel me?
Let's talk about anime.
Let's do it, man.
Anime.
Let's go with this Hunter Hunter artist. Look, when I be seeing anime, bro, it be on some freak nasty. I be seeing Asian girls naked on Twitter.
Boy, you watching the wrong
thing? Oh, shit, that's
hentai. What's on his timeline?
He caught him, bro. He be watching that, Joe.
What's on his timeline? That's the question.
Wait, hold on. One at a time. Okay, what happened?
I said it's hentai, bro. That's like
what they be on.
That's like anime porn, bro. That's just what it is. I know
that's
what it
is. That's what the anime is called.
Yeah, I think that's literally what hentai? Like anime porn calls like hentai. I think something like that.
I don't know about that, bro.
Look, JT,
yeah. I could be wrong.
Go ahead.
Anime is beautiful, right? It's an art story. really, it is the way anime lays out the show that. I think that there's no other type of show that has a character development like anime, because what anime does is like, you think about it, it's usually every anime originated off a comic book, and how comic books, like page by page, picture by picture, frame by frame. So it'll be a scene, bro. And this, you know, some people that don't have patience, I understand that. It'll be a scene though, where they explaining everything down to the minute detail. So you understand everything that's exactly what's happening down to the T. So you get you know what I'm saying? Like it helps a lot with it when it comes to narration and like detail. Like it's detail oriented, bro.
I feel like, bro, I've watched anime. Like,
what introduced you to anime? What did you watch?
What? I started with Naruto, bro. I feel like that's
I feel like that don't count. But that don't count.
How doesn't that count?
Bro. That's a childhood. We all
watch. How does it not count?
I watched Naruto like recently, bro. That's probably like 2 years ago when I started there. I feel like, bro, that's a good one, but it drags, bro. That's why I stopped anime. Anime be dragging sometimes.
It do. I ain't gonna lie. I might want a little anime with a little sex in it. You know what I'm saying? They always spice up a little
freaky. What a little freaky, bro.
What, bro?
He's on that head tie, bro. Come on, bro. We just talked about that.
Hell no.
That's crazy.
Yeah. What else going on, bro? Let's bring up some topics. Let's talk about this dinner we went to, right? What was it called? Jazz.
Yeah.
We went to this little Cajun boil. No, it was a
Cajun boil. I had a burger, bro.
Wait, bro. Cajun boils got burgers too, bro.
Yeah, it was like a Louisiana.
South Louisiana.
Cajun boils could have burgers.
Well, there was Cajun boils in the menu.
But
he said Cajun boils could have burgers. Bro, am I tripping or I'm tripping?
Cajun boils don't only just have Cajun boils. They have other, you know, other little smaller items.
He had.
When I say Cajun boil, I'm thinking like a boil with like some.
Trey had a little Cajun
crawfish.
Burger.
That's what I thought.
Crawfish.
That's
and
what
some,
I was thinking.
Yeah, some shrimp. No, that.
Trey had a little Cajun burger. He had some sausage.
Make sure you in the camera, bro. Just scoot up to the end. You good, bro. You good, bro. You can lean back, bro. I made sure. No, but, bro, the server, bro, she was high.
She was drunk or something.
I think she wanted me.
She was asking for
me. I think she wanted you too, bro. She was talking to you heavy.
I think I just got a good personality and I just crack some good jokes.
Bro, you like a good talker or like jokester or something like that.
You know how to connect with people on that level.
Yeah,
for sure.
And I think that's why the podcast is so good for me, because it's just like, man, I just feel like, bro, black people, we need some therapy, bro. We just need to open up some time, crack some jokes, bro. We be going through it, bro.
Gotta have fun.
Bro, black people be going through it the most, more than anybody. I don't care what nobody say.
Kobe, you snarling all in the mic.
That was me, bro.
Oh, Trey, my come bad. On, bro.
Then he accused Kobe like that, bro.
My bad,
bro.
My bad,
honestly,
bro.
Kobe wiped her nose. Honestly.
My fault.
Bro, but, bro, she wanted me, and it's just like, bro, is it okay to be toxic?
No.
What if you're not in a relationship, though?
No.
That's still not ideal, bro.
Yeah, it's definitely not ideal.
What's your definition of toxic, though?
Toxic is like unnecessary stress put on the two different parties for the fun of it. Like,
that's a hard definition.
It's hard. Yeah. Like, you just putting it's unnecessary stress on both sides for the fun of it. Like, y'all, you're toxic because you want to be toxic. You like the toxic stuff. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's fun. You like that. You like the drama, the in and out, I'm blocking you too, blah, blah, blah. Y'all know y'all finna be back talking to in a week.
That's not me. That's not me. I don't get like
what that. You mean by toxic?
Yeah, so what you mean is
so look. Flirting. That's my toxic. My toxic is like I will flirt with you and make you think I want to be with you, but I have no aspirations.
So leading on. That's what
you're that's leading on.
Like, how's that? Yeah, that's your toxic trait.
Yeah,
is that toxic trait?
Toxic trait is
yeah, that's toxic for sure. Yeah, that's toxic.
100%. What's the toxic traits though?
One right there.
That's number one.
For sure. What about if you purposely not texting your girl back? Is that toxic?
Purposely,
like you not doing nothing. You look at your girl message and you be like, flip the phone over. Look, you looked. You said,
you read it and everything.
Your red receipt's off. You turned it off. You like, I don't feel like dealing with her right now.
I don't know, man. You might not want to be bothered in that moment in time. It could be toxic.
Is that toxic?
Bro. It could be, bro.
It could be.
Yeah, it definitely could
it
be.
It could be.
It depends on the situation.
For sure.
Yeah. What you think, bro?
It's also like, bro, you might tell your girl, you just need some space right now. And she like, bro, you don't love me. You don't want to talk to me.
You don't care.
You don't care, bro. You be like, bro, you don't feel like dealing with that, bro.
Extra. Niggas be tired, bro.
I'm not tired.
Let's talk about your dread journey, bro.
Hey, bro, hold on. How was your dread journey, bro?
Bro.
How did you feel in that ugly stage?
How was the inchworm phase?
Yeah, bro, how was that? How'd that go, bro?
Shit, I just wanted to take a step and just do it all. I just always wanted dreads, though. Like, I ain't always want dreads, but probably, like, when I hit, like, 14, I just always wanted dreads. So I just went ahead and did it, and niggas was frying me up. I mean, it was funny. I was just like, I mean, shit, like, my shit gonna grow, so... Like, a couple years from now, I'm not going to give a fuck. So, shit, that's me right now. Shit, like, I just let the journey take me.
Oh, bro.
I just stopped caring, though. Like, at a certain point, you just stop caring. Like, you just want your shit just to get even longer. Like, even though I made it this far, you feel what I'm saying? Like, I just want it to be longer. Like, I'm not satisfied type shit.
So, you still want them to get longer?
For sure.
How long do you think you want to go, bro?
Not too long, but I know the length I want. So,
okay. True. Did you ever think about yarn?
It's a yarn.
What is yarn? Bro, what is yarn?
Bro, do you remember that one dude? What was that one dude from high school? Chris, or what was his dude name? He had to spray it online.
Oh yeah, yarn. Chris.
Bro.
Yeah.
That was not it.
Yarn? You mean like extensions?
Yes. That was not it.
But I don't know. I never get extensions, bro.
Yeah. Nah.
I mean, it's a preference. You feel me? Like some, I feel like my whole thing is if women can wear their wigs and their extensions, like
why can't men
do it too? I'm not saying I understand. I'm not saying like dudes should be going crazy getting wigs.
Yeah,
I wouldn't do it, but
I wouldn't do it either. You feel me? But you know, you never know what was going on with a person's hair when they do that. You feel me? They might have did that because they were super insecure about it. So they did it. You feel me?
That's just disrespectful.
So what y'all would think if I pulled up one day, I had some lock extensions. Like I'm talking about just slinging, lock slinging. What y'all going to I'm talking about walking, I'm shaking my head. What y'all going to say to me, bro? Y'all going to be like, what y'all going to do? What's y'all first thought?
I'll bake your ass. Shorty,
I'm roasting you.
Yeah.
You're gonna have to take the roast. I'll take that, bro.
Yeah, I would take that, bro.
Bro, what's better, waves or dreads? I'm team waves.
I'm team dreads.
Trey.
I'll go dreads, bro.
You going dreads?
Yeah. I feel like if you keep them looking nice, bro, dreads or locks, some people don't like
dreads. But dreads more expensive, though, bro. You gotta get a haircut. You gotta get a lining. You gotta get a retwist. You gotta dye in your stuff.
That's maintenance.
It's just bro, how it's maintenance. Just maintenance. It's just what come with it. Yeah, you just gotta make that sacrifice.
How often you get a retwist?
Shit, I used to do it like every month or so, but now I'll be doing it like every 2+ months.
So bro, wait, when you be looking, when dreads is looking rough, you looking rough.
My shit looking rough right now. Like,
but he don't got a chop though.
Oh, bro, I don't got a chop. Right, bro, my shit not chop, retwisted.
Chop, retwist, bro. You looking clean,
but you gotta pay how clean. Much though?
I mean, how much a retwist is?
Shit, retwist. The shorty I went to last time, it was like probably like 60 something. That shit, it's annoying though.
I mean, 60's not bad.
That's
I mean,
not crazy. It's
not 60, crazy, not including the haircut. What's the haircut?
Haircut 25. So it's probably like 80, like 90, 85 in total for all that.
That's not that bad, bro. Because you don't get a retwist that often.
For sure.
He said 2 months. Every 2 months, that's waves. How many haircuts you get in 2 months? Because you be wolfing and all that. So
2 months, I'm probably getting like four haircuts.
How much a haircut?
40. Let's talk about these 40. Let's talk about these barber prices. Sheesh. Let's talk about these barber prices, bro. Boom. I don't know what it is. These barbers is crazy.
Yeah, low key.
What's a good price then? What's a good price for a barber in today's climate?
It depends on their quality first. 100%.
But 25.
I'll say 30. Max.
30 max. Okay, I can go 30.
Maybe 35. 35 pushing it, but
yeah. 30 max, 35 pushing it, but yeah, for sure, for sure.
I'm paying 40. Then they be wanting a tip too.
Do y'all tip y'all barbers?
No,
nah.
It's the hell tips.
Actually, sometimes
gratitude is included.
I feel like if I mess with my barber, I'll tip him. Like, yeah. Like my homie Deuce, he chopped me up. I tip him 5. Feel me? Like he chopped. He only charging 25. So
you paying 30.
I paid 30.
I'm paying 40. No tip.
Yeah, that's different. You paying 40?
I'm not throwing tips.
Tips
that's included. Yeah, that's included.
100%. Like my barber at home, bro. I always tip, bro. Cause I mess with dude. Like you saying, you mess with your barber, bro. You gonna throw him a little something extra, bro.
For sure.
He just restored my life. Like he just restored me.
Just made me come out feeling good,
bro. Shorty only love you when you got a haircut.
Cap,
bro.
You just feel better, bro.
I'm saying
confidence you do feel better. Confidence feel is confident, bro. Implemented bro, when you have a haircut.
Your girl treats you different when you ain't got no haircut, bro.
I mean,
she gonna. I mean, shit, you probably gonna treat your girl different. She got her shit done. Her shit looking a little nappy. You know what I'm saying? Like, she piss you off. That's gonna make you more mad. Type shit, bro.
Yo, bald head. Look.
That's funny, bro.
Would you beg your shorty? How far is you going too far in baking your shorty? Can you bake up like a wig looking rough?
I'd like, be frying my shorty.
You be frying her, bro.
Yeah,
bro.
Well, I don't fry her, but
it's a helpful plate.
I point it out.
You
it's but a plan though. Yeah.
I mean, if the wig looking rough, you can point it out.
Oh, bro,
that's probably the better thing to do. You want your shorty walking around with a fucked up wig? That shit gonna look bad on you.
He down bad.
It says gonna look bad on you.
Hell yeah.
Oh yeah, I feel the same way, bro. I feel the same way.
I feel like baking comes with relationships. What y'all think about that?
100%. If like you can't joke
joking
with me,
around with your
yeah.
If I can't like joke with you, I don't even wanna.
That's what I'm saying.
Part of the fun.
It's part of the fun. We can cook each other up, bro.
That'd be funny as shit.
I love baking my shorty, I ain't gonna lie. It's a fun thing to do. Like just baking her up,
bro. Bro, do y'all like
I get thrills from it.
Nigga generally get the rushes, bro. That's crazy.
Do y'all like antagonizing y'all girl? Like just annoying her, just to know you bothers her sometimes.
Sometimes, bro.
Yeah, if I'm in that mood,
yeah sometimes.
Fuck with her type shit. Just cause I want to, like
OB.
Just cause I want to piss her off.
No, just you toxic. You toxic.
Bro, hell no, I ain't toxic. A little bit, but
it's the dreads.
Not too much.
It's the dreads.
Dread.
What would you do if a girl cut your dreads off?
If she cut them off.
What you doing?
Damn, I'll probably just cry.
You would cry, bro.
Yeah.
Would you shake her?
Oh my god!
Is it okay to shake your girl?
Red flag,
you saying
bro.
If my girl cut them off?
What you
saying? My girl. If it's like a random shorty, like she might get like a fucking like she might get slapped for sure. But it's my girl, then like. I'll just probably just never talk to her again. Like that's like a different level of disrespect.
We talking like all saying? Every dread coming off his head.
Every dread, or just one.
Like, what if she just takes the first two in the front?
Like, even if it's just the first two, I'll just like go to a beautician and just ask her to just relock that shit.
Oh, bro.
Oh, bro. bro. I might have to wait like a little bit though, so my hair can grow, so they can lock it into like my hair that grow in. But I mean, I could always reattach dreads, so it won't be that.
Hey, you ever had?
Oh yeah, I forgot you can reattach
barrel,
your dreads.
Like the barrel. You barrel know what I'm talking about? Yeah, you ever had those?
Yeah, I had those. You that ain't, was you like ain't a mess while, with it? That was a while ago.
You ain't mess with it for real.
I mean, it was decent. Yeah, it was just some new shit.
Yeah,
gotta try the styles. I'm finna get dreaded up.
When? When you doing that?
Before next time, I don't even want to get another retwist. I just want to dread up now.
Yeah, you just want 2-strand.
Yeah, 2-strand dreads for now,
bro. I want to start too.
Cause it's like at this point, we getting so much. We do so much maintenance on our twists. We put more maintenance in for than dread people do. 100%.
Do your shorty do your twist?
Yeah.
Is it wrong if you go to another shorty to do her twist? Y'all, I know y'all be seeing the videos. Some shorty be saying they can do head. They want you to come over it. They trying to get in your draws.
I feel like that's kind of like a.
It's true though.
You guys, some shorty says she can do your hair.
Shit, yeah. Some shorties. I mean, shorties just be mad about that, especially when you got dreads. Like it's always some shit like, well, what shorty finna be retwisting your hair? Woo, woo. Just like, damn, nigga, I'm just trying to get my hair retwisted.
Bro. Fuck, he said, I'm trying to look good for the month.
Damn, bro.
I don't care about shorty.
Like, this the same thing as my barber. It's just a shorty. Motherfucker just retwisted my shit.
Funny, bro.
Yeah, I feel like twist, you put more maintenance into your twist than you do for a dress. Like, because anytime every time we get retwisted, we got to take the twist out, wash the hair. Yeah. We got to blow dry it all the way out, oil it up. Part it again, repart it, right?
I gotta do a lot of
everything,
shit,
bro. And then we gotta get your whole retwisted. That process be hours and it hurts, okay, bro.
So wait, your shorty do your twist, retwist?
Yeah.
When she first started, was she good?
Yeah, but my hair was short when I first started, so it didn't look good. Like,
was it your hair or was it her?
It was my hair, bro. I had like the doo-doo worms. Like,
would you hold your girl accountable if she messed
up? I remember
up?
For we
of both. Course, bro.
Do you resent her for the week?
No.
If I had hair, bro, and my shorty messed my stuff up, I'm starting an argument.
I feel like she don't mess it up, though. You gonna start an argument?
Bro, I'm just gonna.
She ain't have to do it, especially it's free.
Yeah.
She ain't have. You can't even get mad, bro.
You can't
get
mad. But you ain't know what you was doing, though.
Yeah. I don't know, bro. Like,
is it okay to shake your shorty?
What you mean? What does that mean?
So.
Shank?
No, shake.
I don't know
he
what
said
he
shank.
I don't know what he said, bro.
Shake. Shake.
What you mean by that?
So. No domestic violence. We don't condone that on the pod. None of that. But you know, sometimes, bro, your shorties be acting a fool, bro. And like, you ever had a shorty try to get physical with y'all, and you don't hit her, but you just
yes,
shake her brains.
Yeah.
Mm. Was that wrong,
bro? It depends, like what's going on in the situation, bro. That's all.
Yeah, it definitely depends.
Is it like, cause if it's playfully, then it makes sense.
No, what about not playfully? She was acting up, bro.
Nah,
she's acting up like what?
Like what you mean, bro?
Is she beating on you? Like that's what you mean?
Is she hitting you? Or
we
she
have
not
to
you?
Give that perspective of people that are getting beat on in this world, bro. There's some men there to get beat on by their girl.
She's beating on me, and you're asking, is it okay for me to shake her?
And we getting beat on? That's the question.
And I'm getting full flesh.
If I'm not getting beat, no.
No, bro.
What if you getting beat?
I'm getting beat. Yes,
I'm saying
you gotta shake.
They gonna get a shake.
A shake is not a shake. Hey, look, I'm showing you my strength without showing you my strength.
Bro, they gonna get a rumble out of me.
I don't think a shake is domestic violence,
but it could be.
That
can leave some bruises with the grip.
Oh, bro,
you got some. That could be if they take that is violence.
Oh yeah,
they taking that. You could go to jail for that.
They finna look at you like abuser.
Yeah,
for sure.
You know what's so messed up, bro? Bro, a girl could call the police right now and say we was beating on them, bro, and we can go to jail right away. But if we say a shorty beating on them, they might not even go to jail, bro.
Yeah, it's a double standard, but
yeah, man, 12 probably gonna pull up and just maybe even laugh at that shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they wouldn't look at the situation the same way from shorty to man.
Because what about a Krishan type?
Bro, I was just thinking
about bash you in the head with a bottle.
Bro, she hit him with a Douce bottle, bro.
Dude, he cut open.
Gashed his head open.
Gashed. That's just scary. Mm-hmm. That's different.
Or like, bro, she be beating on him like outside on public name. He gets strong. Like they bashing Blueface. Bro, she be beating on him.
Strong. She a strong little shorty strong, too, bro. She not. She a little weak.
You seen she was deadlifting?
She deadlift like 315.
315.
She picked that shit up.
Shorty, she drink a Henny bottle a day.
Yes.
Low key.
Anything is possible.
Anything is not possible. That bitch is crazy.
She be wildin', bro.
She need to put that Henny down.
So we just seen DDG and Ruby. He got caught up.
And he make a song saying that's not the shirt, though?
He did. He said it wasn't the shirt, but he did say he sent the message.
Where?
The DM to Ruby.
Oh, yeah, bro. She leaked that, though.
She did. It's in the
city. And he started the convo. Yeah. So I don't really understand.
You still in L.A.?
He was trying to get some cheeks.
He was. Yeah,
what was his his intentions behind that message?
We know what it was.
As a nigga, you 100%. Know.
So he was trying to J down.
What you say, Kobe?
As a nigga, you know, for sure. DDG was definitely on some, he was on some slimy shit.
He was on some grimy, bro.
Like, I'm sorry, DD, but.
DD.
Bro, did Haley, Holly, whatever her name is, definitely did her slimy.
Was that cheating?
The mermaid.
Was that cheating, though?
No, it wasn't.
Apparently,
it was
they
cheating,
would. Remember, they unfollow each other and everything. That was real still.
Oh, Hallie and.
Yeah, they unfollow each other on Instagram.
Before that?
She just unfollowed him. She unfollowed him, though.
She unfollowed him. But if you listen to his song he just dropped, he say, like, I texted. Basically, I hit Ruby up. It's true. He said, but I was in tour with. He's basically saying, like, he was in tour with Shorty at the time. When he hit her up, he admitted to it. Like they was not messing with each other during that time. But like,
so
he
they
still
wasn't
slimy.
Even together when he did all that.
Well, we don't know the context, but that's, I mean, bro, whatever it was, it sounds slimy. It sounded like she was mad at him for something. They was mad at each other, and he went and hit Ruby up. That's pretty much the preface,
bro. Yeah, this is no excuse for guys, bro. But we just be sometimes, bro. Like we get into it with our shorties, we just don't think. We just do stuff. Like he probably didn't even care about Ruby. He was just him and his shorty getting into it. He just gonna hit a bop up.
He trying to venture out real quick.
Yeah, he just trying to hit a little bop.
Yeah.
Shit, Ruby a little piece though.
Yeah.
Ruby's a bop.
She's a bop, but that's a piece. Shit. What did you talk about?
If you had a girl and Ruby, she's trying to get on, what you doing? You leaving?
Oh my goodness.
I'm not leaving, but. Shit.
Bro,
ain't no
Ruby,
bro. Ain't no way I'm leaving.
Oh,
not leaving.
No, for Ruby, bro. She be on the net,
bro.
She be on the net. Huh? It's wilding out. Ain't no way.
Ruby Rose,
damn, for one
that's
night.
A, I don't know, man. I can't.
She trying to throw them Packers on you. Packers,
man.
No way.
Yeah, I mean, look, shit.
Probably, I salute you.
I don't know. Probably not.
I salute
you.
You
a good man.
Ain't no way, bro.
You a good man.
I salute you.
Jalen, what's the word with that Ruby, bro?
If I'm single right now?
I'm saying the question you asked, bro.
If I was in a relationship?
Yeah.
No.
No? Yeah, bro. I feel like that's real slimy.
Because.
Yeah, no. Yeah, I agree.
Y'all switching up?
No.
Nah,
Ruby bad. Ruby bad, bro.
Ruby bad.
That's all. I'm just saying she bad, bro. Like,
yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I couldn't.
But I wouldn't leave something good I have for Ruby, which I know is temporary.
No, yeah, me either.
Because Ruby, one of them shorties, she get bored with you too easy. She got 15 other in her phone. Like, Ruby don't care about you. Like, you for the night, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, bro.
That's crazy.
Yeah. What about big girls?
Big girls?
I mean, shit, big girls.
What about them?
Let's say you're doing a two-man. But we got a four-man. We got two suitables and
two bigs.
Two bigs.
I'm not taking the bigs.
bro, like, you going to take one for the team?
Do we rock,
take one for the team?
We not rock, paper, scissors. We going to have to fight over who getting the bigs.
We got to throw hands.
Throwing hands?
Bro, I'm just, have to be hands, bro. I'm not. Nah, bro.
You would just have to be cool. You would just have to be cool with her, bro.
I'm going
to
be cool, bro.
Yeah, you just have to sit there and make a friend. Make a friend real quick.
If I'm on the night, I'm going to be cool, folks. You know what I'm saying?
Are you a bad homie if you don't entertain a big girl?
Entertaining is.
I say yes. I say yes.
I mean, if it's that scenario where, like, the other two, or the other girls wasn't messing with you and she's the last one, and you know if you don't mess with her, she gonna mess up the vibe for them too.
Yes,
you a bad homie.
You a man.
L man.
That's the label right there.
L man.
Yeah, you gotta take that one, bro. Just be cool. Don't do too much with the big. You know what I'm saying?
Do you have to do something?
No, no shot.
What is she trying to do?
What is she trying to?
She's trying to hop on top, bro. You moving around, bro. You get away, bro.
But if she don't get none, nobody else get none. She on that?
No.
What?
Then no.
No.
I'm not going.
you crazy?
I'm
bro.
Not going.
Yeah, hell no. No.
Okay.
That's not it.
That shit.
I'm a L man's at that point.
L man's?
Yeah.
Do y'all have Riz?
I feel like I got Riz.
I got Riz too. You in a relationship though?
No, I don't got no Riz.
But
you got Riz, bro.
Bro, you could still. You would know if you have Riz.
How did you pull your shorty?
Like Riz? I don't. What you mean by Riz?
Like you got game?
You know what Riz
like
is.
You could pull is what.
Look,
you could pull.
Yeah, I feel like I
could
pull.
Like you could. Look. Like you could J down, like if a shorty was like right here or something, or you walking in the mall. And you see, it's like a group of shorties, and you want to talk to one. You could like wrist her up or like pull her tight. Like you got enough game.
I feel like I could, but I've never been the type to do it.
Okay.
I've never been like if it's it. Let's say like if I was single and I was a shorty, I seen it tomorrow or something like. I probably 9 times out of 10 would not even say nothing. To be honest, like it's I've literally shot my shot. I could count on my hand a few times ever. Honestly.
Oh, bro.
I'm being real.
I don't really shoot my shot.
I don't never
shoot
my shot.
I'm handling shorty with.
Oh, dude, no.
Nah, nah.
What's your go to? What's your? Nah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna give a little sauce.
I feel like eye contact is.
No, eye contact is so key. Like, shorty's gonna let you know about the eyes. Yeah. Shorty's not gonna shoot their shot. They shot is.
Yeah,
y'all. You gonna lock eyes? You gonna lock eyes a few times? You know that look? You know that look when it's like it's time to execute.
For sure.
But. What I'm gonna do, everybody gonna go down. We gonna give our scenario. You meet a shorty in a club, you meet her somewhere, you trying to get the number. I'm gonna go up, you know what I'm saying? Let's say we out, it's a little club, a little bar, or something like that. I'm gonna go up and talk to her. I'm like, just like, hey, where you from? You know what I'm saying? Just get the little information, you know what I'm saying? I'm an entertainer, whatever she is. I don't buy drinks. Do y'all buy drinks?
I mean, you could. Only one?
If you want.
Yeah, it's really like, I don't know.
Is buying a drink okay?
I ain't buying drinks. Bro.
Be either. Be either,
you know,
bro.
I catch
buying drinks.
Be either, bro.
Yeah.
I never bought a drink, so I don't really know, but.
The people that do, that's on them.
Okay.
But I ain't buying no drink for some shorty that I just met for. Like,
I agree.
Ain't no way.
Yeah, but you know what I'm going to tell her, though? I'm going to sauce up, give her a little small talk. You know, I'm trying to rotate. Like, let me get your jersey. You know what she gonna say? Jersey, what?
Mm-hmm.
Your name and your number.
I can mess with that, bro.
W or L?
I think it's a W.
That's I can mess w. with that, bro.
If I was a shorty, I'm thinking like that's cold. That's different.
I tried to think of the answer, like what she was gonna
bro,
say. I couldn't even think.
Either
of
she gonna say Jersey, she gonna laugh Jersey, or she be like, what? Your name and your number. What's on a jersey? What's
hard.
On a jersey?
That's
you know
hard.
What I'm saying? That's my go-to.
Yeah. That's hard.
But you got to say it the right way. Not everybody can use that line. So that's a disclaimer. Don't just go, don't just go on the streets.
Bro.
You got to have that red. Make sure you're looking straight. You know what I'm saying?
So
now that's a W right there.
So, how do y'all know when a shorty is being friendly to you? Or how do you know when... She trying to get on that with you then.
What you mean?
Like she's
just doing it just to do it. She just flirting,
like
fake
being
flirting.
She being friendly, like she just being cool. Like she just being cool. She being her regular personality is probably just friendly. You know what I'm saying? Like, or how do you know when she actually like trying to flirt with you? Like what's the social cues of like you maybe
in person?
Like,
that's hard.
In person. Or yeah, like texting or
in person.
Mm.
What's the social cues to know like yeah she flirting with me for sure. And she's not just being friendly, like just to be cool. Like, was she after with her friends? Would you ever mess with him? Like, heck, no. I was just talking. I'm just being me. Like, chopping it up. Like, he just my friend. Or like, I just know him. Like, you feel me? Or you leave. She leaving. They ask her, and they like, she like, girl, I don't even know what to. I couldn't even know what to say to him. Like, well, what's the social cues of that?
Trey, go first, bro.
Bro, I feel like, bro, I've seen like if a girl like start, I don't know, bro. I feel like playing with their hair or something. Kind of like
the hair.
Kind of like not they doing something extra. They doing something extra that they wouldn't normally do. Like being nervous or something. Yeah, like
type shit.
Acting kind of nervous. I feel like that's something I don't know for real. Like something like that though.
Can we go over? Let me hear what you guys
think.
Say,
what you think, bro?
I think it depends how she looking at you and like how she's saying the shit that she's saying to.
Yeah, the way she talking.
The verbiage? You talking about the verbiage?
Yeah, because, I mean, there's obviously be a lot of friendly-ass shorties who just be mad friendly.
They just doing it just to do
like,
it, bro.
You feel what I'm saying? You hit her up. She on some dry shit. You feel what I'm saying? Like, but, I mean, you just got to differentiate with the look, I guess, and just, I guess, talk and just find out yourself type shit. You feel what I'm saying? Like, do your riz or whatever.
Do your riz, bro.
Bro. See me, I'm a natural flirt, bro. I'm a flirt back. And I gotta see how it's coming. You know what I'm saying? Like maybe, you know what I'm saying? I'ma set up a certain joke, a certain sum to see like what's her response gonna be. And that's gonna tell me what it really is. If she playing, I'm gonna be able to tell by the response. But if she going along with it, that's how I kinda like, yeah.
So you kinda setting up.
I'm setting
you
up.
Setting it up.
I'm setting up a test.
I feel that. Yeah, you do get your, you do get that based off that answer,
like what you did today at the restaurant with the waitress.
Yeah,
what was that? What, did I miss that?
No, you didn't miss it. Remember, he rizzed her kind of. She was. Oh like, yeah, yeah, it was like he kind of set the joke out like, and she kind of bit on it for sure. Like,
for sure,
she bit on that.
She bit on it.
She cool at that. Bro, is it wrong in relationships to like test your girl, set them up to see what they gonna do?
As far as like cheating,
DIY or the dude who won't be, what's his name on YouTube, who be like posting them like set up that you set your shorty up or set your dude up on the whole scheme to see if they.
Bro, I be watching this dude. His name Jack TV. Bro, he be doing those. Bro, y'all got to tune in there. He be catching cheaters all the time.
Yeah, bro. Like, is it okay to set your girl up, like put on a loyalty test, or like tell one of your homies to go get on, like see what your girl gonna say.
A loyalty test, damn.
Yeah, is it wrong?
Bro, only it's wrong if she's not giving those signs. But I feel like if she's giving kind of those signs, you feeling some type of way about the way she moving, bro, you could kind of set that up. I feel like it's only right if, you know what I'm saying?
I think it's only wrong if you get caught.
I feel, yeah, bro.
I ain't setting shit up.
I agree with you, Trey. For like, yeah, I ain't never said, I would never say nothing up. But if I were to set something up, it would only because if like it was cues to tell me, like, I need to find out, bro, because I don't feel right.
Right.
But if she ain't never thrown them signs, ain't no way I'm finna just set up a loyalty test. You know how goofy you look, bro?
No reason. Yeah,
like,
yeah,
you
that
look
shit
dumb.
Goofy, bro. That shit is chopped.
Stop, bro. That'll be issues in a relationship because of that, bro.
For real.
Yeah, definitely.
For real. So,
yeah. I'll be mad if she pulls some shit like that on me. Like,
yeah, bro.
Like, what the fuck is you doing, bro?
Like, what if the cameras come out and you're all up in your face? Like, bro, you passed the loyalty test.
Bro, I'll be like, bro, hell no. We done now. Fuck you. I don't play that, bro.
That's chuck, bro.
Yeah.
Bro. What y'all, What are y'all thoughts on why are there a lot of women that are attracted to men with money? What is the why is that?
So they could get taken care of.
The lifestyle.
They don't have to pay for certain things. They kind of just get things for free. Damn near. That's what I think.
They want to be lazy.
Bro, I was just gonna ask that. Are those women lazy, bro?
You feel me? No. Here's what I gotta say. Like,
are you saying women lazy?
Nah, I'm saying that girls. I mean, you obviously have a right to go for the richest motherfucker you see. You feel what I'm saying? Like, if that's what you want to go for, you want to go for a successful dude, go for that. But you feel me? Are you really going for him? For him, or are you obviously going for him for his money? So there's obviously a fucking difference. You feel what I'm saying?
That's true.
Yeah, that was a good answer, because I feel like it was even like when I was watching Kai live, right? Mm-hmm. Ruby Rose is on the live, and he say, and the dude was asking him questions, like spicy questions, whatever. And he say, if Kai didn't have the money and the success he had, like, would you have even ever shown him the light of day and been in this room? She said, yeah.
She's capping.
She was like, yeah. Kai is a 5'5 African.
Bro.
Yeah, cap.
Bro, that's foul.
5'5.
That's crazy. Kai got a great personality. For he can vibe with anybody.
He does, though.
Dude can vibe with anybody, bro.
But Ruby's capping if she's saying she's just, oh, she just gave Kai the time of the
day. Yeah, she's capping. She's capping. She's saying that shit just because.
Is Kai a L man's for flirting with Ruby, even though he's had DDG on the stream and they homies?
Well, Kai fucking boy, hell no, bro.
Oh, that's L man. That's L man's, bro.
He be flirting with her?
Yes.
They was flirting on that stream, bro. I ain't gonna lie.
He be calling
Ruby wasn't flirting, bro. It was just really Kai, like Kai tweaking. Like,
what's wrong with that, boy? Kai do that shit. He's doing that shit for the streams, though, too.
Yeah, he doing. I feel like he do some stuff for entertainment.
That's what I'm saying,
bro. But Trey, if I was flirting your girl for entertainment for my podcast,
that's not even DDG girl
no
more.
That's not his girl, bro.
DDG got a whole nother girl.
But we don't know what happened behind the scenes. DDG, he could have asked DDG, you cool with Ruby Brown on the live, bro?
Yeah,
like,
he could have asked
him. He was like, bro, I don't care about shorty, bro. He probably was like, bro, I don't care what you asking me for. Why are you asking me?
Is it okay for your homies to date your ex, though?
No.
None?
Not my most recent one. And it depends how old it is. It depends how old it is.
Super
bro.
Old ex. Like, yeah. I have no feelings left. Like, there's like no feelings left.
And you have to
body.
Ask me. You have to confirm it with me,
for
bro.
Sure, yeah.
You have to confirm it with me.
Is there a cap of how many you can keep off limits?
How many old relationships?
Yeah. Celeste, your homie, not saying he just looking for all your girls, but it's like, bro, I feel like everybody got that one person, like, no, that's she off dibs.
I don't got that person. I don't think. They my exes for a reason.
Don't answer this.
What you mean?
I don't think you should answer.
Answer what?
The question.
What's the question again?
Is it okay to have like exes on dibs? Like, or basically like your homies can't. Bro, let's say you got five exes. Three of them, you're like, okay, they're my ex, but I don't really care. If my homie get off. Because I was like, bro, do you want your homie happy? If that shorty can make your homie happy, are you a L man for holding that back?
But why are you holding it back is the question. If that's your ex.
But like, you got to understand, though. Yeah, that's your ex, but it's also like, you know, like, you had soul ties with a certain person.
Bro, I don't know, bro.
Kobe, what you think, bro? You understand
Kobe,
what I'm saying,
ahead,
bro?
Go ahead and say something, bro.
Shit.
Is
it
okay?
I don't know. As a homie, it's just like, why the fuck is you even all these girls? Why are you going for my fucking ex though?
That's weird.
You know what I'm saying?
It is weird.
They locked in. That's what happened. They locked in.
That is kind of weird, bro.
All these shorties in the world, you want to go out there with my old news? be for real. What they be saying? Be? Well, no, I ain't gonna say that, bro.
Then that's gonna make shit weird. So,
I mean, if someone ever asked me, I'd be like, I don't care. I wouldn't care. I have no feelings for my exes, so I wouldn't care. But I was still in the back.
I don't think it's about the feelings, though.
But in the back of my mind, I would think that was weird that you want to go for my ex, though.
That's the weirdest thing ever. Because
why do you want to? Why?
Why her?
Why her? That means while I was dating her, you had some feelings. Like you was thinking about her. Like
you seen her some type of way.
You seen her that way. Yeah, you supposed to be looking at her like the sister.
You shaking my hand every day. You coming up to my face, but then you trying to get my girl.
I'm saying,
bro.
If you had the chance, too.
You a snake.
100%. That ain't right, bro.
Snake shit.
By any means.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. No shot.
I still do think it's like, it's like some that's off limits.
But yeah, everybody's different, bro.
Yeah.
Everybody has like, they old relationships have some type of tie on them. So everybody has a different, you know what I'm saying, bond with their ex or whatever it might be. But
you know
what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. What's another really spicy question?
Who's up right now? Light skins or dark skins?
Bro, what?
Dark skins.
Dark skins, for sure.
Dark skins been up for a
little bit. They're up, bro.
They've been up for a minute now, bro.
You are light skinned, so.
I'm going to disagree, bro. I think y'all had COVID. Y'all had coronavirus. Y'all had the pandemic, bro. We done rolled ties back, bro.
Hell no.
Light skins, we back up now, bro.
No, sir.
Bro, you be watching them.
Y'all up because y'all ain't getting no sunlight right now, bro. That's the main reason, bro. I ain't gonna lie.
Oh, my God.
You need some sunlight, bro.
Shorty, we bouncing back, bro. Dark skins, what's up, bro? Like,
are you telling me you think light skin's up right now?
Yeah.
Hell no.
What, you drunk, bro?
Light skins are not up right now.
Bro, you are drunk, bro.
Bro, we on a comeback. Like, we hit a recession. We on the comeback right now. You know what I'm saying? You know, we got high buying pressure. S&P is going up, you know. Economy's getting better.
What's my economy? Nah, man.
Yeah. Yeah. What's some things college taught y'all, though?
No, bro.
What's dating in college like?
Me and Trey can answer that then. Yeah.
Oh, bro.
Yeah.
What you Kobe? Think, what you think about? You any situationships out here?
I mean, shit. I had a couple, but none I really wanted to pursue shit further with.
Is it true these women out here are shiesty?
Very. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, but I think dudes be shiesty too, though. Yeah, everybody's shiesty, bro.
It's in college. Everybody.
Everybody got some type of shiest to them.
True.
Was dating like in college?
Dating in college is cool if you make it cool. I feel like it's like if you dating in college and you got struggles with like trying to stay loyal, or you got struggles with like thinking about what could have been with other women, and you probably made the wrong decision getting in a relationship, bro. It's not an easy task, because it's certain things like you want to pop out with the guys and slide to woo woo, but you know it's like, why would I even go there? I know what's there. I know I if I'm sliding to this move, it's the kickback. You know what I'm saying? It's not that many people that for like, do I need to be in that space, bro?
Tight.
What's really going down now? You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't need, but like when you single, you know, like if I was single, I would have went. Why not? You know what I'm saying? I'm single. I can go wherever I want.
Hell yeah.
So it's like, if you're okay with like some experiences you won't have, but if you supplement that with experiences with your shorty, which to me is 10 times better than experiencing with some random shorty for the night or, you know, XYZ. You know, I think it's real solid.
Yeah, it's what you make it, bro. Like, if you want to date in college, then you should. But if you know, like, you just trying to mess around or whatever, then don't even indulge in that. For real. So, that's what I take.
That's a good take.
Yeah, man.
That's a W take, 100%.
W take.
What's the difference between y'all high school relationships y'all had and college relationships? It's the same thing, or just it's a different ball game.
Different ball game.
Yeah.
Shit, it's the same right now, but I'm only a freshman though, so I can only say so much. You know what I'm saying?
I feel you. I hear you. Man, bro,
it's a different ball game, bro. Because you, where you at in your life, especially like, let's say like for me and Trey, we juniors in college, bro. We looking out 1 year from now. We be looking out into, you know, we're on our last semester of college, seniors finna graduate and going to the workforce, you know what I'm saying? So like it's a lot of different things that's going through your mind. You going through different processes with goals and aspirations, and you know, different, you're trying to find internships, all type of stuff. Like different stuff that's happening, you're trying to mature. That plays a different role into your relationship of like what you thinking about in a relationship, you feel me? Like the type of goals you got for your relationship. You know what I'm saying? You never know if your girl might get a job in San Diego and you in Chicago or something, you feel me? Like, that's the type of stuff you got to think about, you feel me, as well. And like, I don't know, high school, you was not really in love in high school. You was just infatuated, bro, you feel me? Like,
yeah.
The older you get, you realize, like, that love, bro, that stuff come, like, where you don't even, where you at the point where, like, man, it's no longer this puppy love stuff, bro. Like, we in this together and it's tough, but we going to build on it, you feel me? Like, 100%. It's different, bro, for sure.
Hey, so what's dating like outside of college, like not being at school?
That's a good question.
Yeah, like how has that been for you?
It's definitely different now, because I'm in a pool now. Like, I'm dating an older woman, like late 20s, early 30s. I've dated like some women that's in college. So it's just kind of, it's a different ball game, because some stuff you be dealing with people that in your age, you don't deal with people that's older than you. Or just some stuff, or you kind of see some stuff that older people are, you would think they don't do that no more. They still do the same stuff as younger. So it's kind of like, you can see the pros and cons of both situations.
True.
And it just gets to a point now where it's like, I'm learning how to date casually. And not every person you text, or, you know what I'm saying, y'all get in a relationship. I feel like, we texting the girl, like, bro, we started talking 3 months, and then I just, like, feel obligated to get in a relationship where, like, it just happened. So just me really taking the time now to just process everything, really figure out what I want, and just take the time and really just working on me right now. But dating while you are older, like college, like y'all, you know what I'm saying? School is y'all number one focus. Y'all can't really focus on the bread. Like me, no, I'm on some travel, like dating. Like we taking trips. We going to Mexico. We going to, you know what I'm saying, these different countries and just experiencing the world with different people and seeing their perspective on life and, you know, just experience life with different things. Like that's what I'm really about right now. So it's real different from college because like y'all can't just go up and leave for a whole trip. You know what I'm saying? Y'all gotta wait till spring break. You know what I'm saying? You might not have the funds to be able to travel. Mm-hmm. But so, what's the best late night snack? I'm saying Fruit Loops.
Cap.
Late night snack.
You eat Captain Crunch?
No, I don't.
What's your cereal?
I'm a Cocoa Pebbles type of dude.
Cocoa Pebbles? That's number one?
No, I'm not saying it's my number
well,
one.
Well, late night snack? Like
that's no, that's number one. Said, that's what he went to.
That's my number one cereal. I like Cocoa Pebbles. The chocolate milk full, like I can go crazy with some Cocoa Pebbles. So.
Damn.
Yeah, late what night, cereal? Give me some Cocoa Puffs. If I'm fried, feel me? A little weed, power nap, wake up, Cocoa Pebbles, Cocoa Puffs. Either what about, go crazy.
What about Fruity Pebbles?
Bro, Fruity Pebbles, they only good when they soggy, though.
Ew.
That's just disgusting.
That like.
Bro, you foul,
that
bro.
So disgusting. I haven't had Fruity Pebbles in years.
Yo, it's not valid. Anything you about to say right now.
Nah, bro, you can't defend yourself, bro. That's over.
Yo,
bro.
I don't want.
L take, bro. No, I don't want
to
hear it no more.
Not to the point like.
Chewing perspective.
Next question.
Soggy Fruity Pebbles, bro. Nasty as hell.
That's so foul,
bro. You eat Captain Crunch, bro. What's the worst cereal, though?
The best cereal?
Raisin Bran.
Yeah, Raisin Bran.
You tried it before?
I ain't even had it before. That's the first thing that came to my mind.
He tried
it. No, I swear I ain't had no Raisin Bran.
He tried it.
All right, bro. All right.
Raisin Bran.
He said that a little too quick.
First thing that came to my mind, bro.
Raisin Bran, weak as hell, for sure. I think the worst cereal, though, probably is like, I don't know. Like, I ain't fucking with that cookie. I ain't fucking with that Cookie Crisp.
Bro, I was finna say that.
Yo, that shit is
y'all
terrible.
Tripping.
Bro,
I got Cookie Crisp in the cabinet. Amari,
bro. You remember that one time I had Cookie Crisp? I wanted to try it, bro. And I was like, bro, it's not good. I thought it was going to be good.
Bro, Allie, so like, my girl, she had some Cookie Crisp. I had the Cookie Crisp.
Nah.
She said, should I eat Cocoa Pebbles or Cookie Crisp? I said, man, eat the Cookie Crisp, fool. I got some. I got a family size box.
Family size is crazy.
I dumped the bowl. I'm hyping it up. She ate it. She's eating it. She told me, this is terribly mid. And I was looking at her like, dang, I started eating like, is this really mid, bro? Have I been like deceiving my mind?
Bro, I'm telling you, Cookie Crisp
is
not
eating?
Good.
That shit is ass, bro.
Man.
Cookie Crisp is ass. I'm sorry. Like, that shit not
it. Do I need to pour y'all a bowl real quick so y'all can test it out?
Hell no.
Bro, what's the best milk? I'm going Red Cap.
That's whole, right? That's
whole? Yeah, whole. That's whole.
I don't know the
difference. You mean 2%, bro.
Nah, bro. It don't matter to me.
Blue Cap.
Blue Cap.
Red Cap is crazy. It's Blue Cap.
Whoa.
Don't do
Red Cap. Red Cap. You saying all milk tastes the same?
No, I'm saying Red Cap and Blue Cap, it don't matter. I mess with both.
They Red Cap and Blue Cap are a little similar.
I mess with both, bro.
I'm Red Cap, bro.
Whatever in the fridge is going.
I'm a Blue Cap.
I go Red Cap. I go Red Cap.
I'll go Blue.
Pancakes or waffles?
Pancakes.
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 Bacon or sausage?
Bacon.
Bacon?
Bacon, 100%.
Bacon. So
what's another one? Honey buns or Little Debbie's? Look, Cosmic Brownies, bro.
Yo,
honey buns or Cosmic Brownies?
Honey buns.
Honey buns.
Honey buns.
Which honey buns, though? Not the. I don't like the regular honey buns. They cool. It's the.
No, don't talk about that white swirl bullshit.
No.
White swirl.
You talk about them sweet ass.
I know what you're talking about. The big ones.
Yeah, bro.
Like Big Texas.
Oh, Big Texas. Those good.
No, not though.
You're
it's like a honey
white,
bun,
but it's white.
It's like a honey bun. It kind of looks like a Big Texas a little bit,
but it got white on. White on the top.
Oh, bro!
I used to have them Big Texas at high school games.
High school games, bro. I used to like
warm them up.
Should I get the Big Texas? Yeah.
I used to tell them throw that mug in the microwave, bro. It used to be so.
Bro,
good.
I just had a Big Texas at the football game first semester. Y'all was frying my ass though.
Bro, these are the best honey bun.
Dutch's honey buns.
I
ain't never seen
that. I never had. I usually eat the Little Debbie ones, so I never really tried those.
Yeah, bro, getting some BS on
cosmic brownies or zebra cakes.
Zebra cakes.
Cosmics.
Cosmics.
You're
crazy. Zebra cakes?
Cosmics.
What the heck?
Cosmics.
Hey, I don't think I ever had a zebra cake.
Listen,
I ain't had one either. I was like, cosmic.
I had a zebra cake.
Look. Eat a cosmic brownie right now, bro. That shit is ass, bro.
The cosmic brownies low key aren't.
Eat one right now. That shit is terrible. We ain't kids no more, nigga. Let's act real, nigga. Zebra cakes are better than cosmic brownies.
I got one. Cup noodles or noodles like the real ones?
Package noodles.
Package or cup?
Package
or cup.
Package.
Yeah, package. Stove. When it's made right, package.
Stove or microwave?
Microwave.
What you mean stove or microwave?
Stove or microwave noodles.
You know, I do microwave now because I just don't even feel like putting that in the pot no more.
But yeah, if you had the time.
Microwave is cool, bro.
If you had the time, what are you doing?
I'm still doing microwave.
You're a trifling.
Because it's microwave. Like,
what's the difference?
Bro, the pot,
it's
bro,
a different flavor, bro.
No, it's not.
Why did you just tell me the stove has a different flavor?
Shorty, you're getting the radiation. How? You're getting the radiation.
What radiation?
What do you think? Microwave? Oh, there's radio waves.
No, bro, that's what
I know.
Got
you're not saying the radio waves is in your noodles, bro. That's what you're trying to tell me.
That's what you're trying to say?
Yes.
You wildin' for that.
It's a different flavor.
How long? Okay, have you ever used the microwave for noodles?
I've tried it.
How long you leave them in there for?
It got to be right time.
I don't do it enough.
Let me know your time, bro.
No.
If you was to make something right
now. Let me give you my stove.
No. Wait, this is what I'm asking. Listen. What's your microwave time for your noodles, bro? This going to tell me everything I need to know. I promise you.
I don't put it in the microwave.
Bro, if you had to right now, if I was like, bro, I got some noodles, you hungry? That's not bad, bro.
What are you?
How we doing, 5?
You're so mushy.
Dang, I mean, bro, it's noodles.
I'm expecting 5.
I'll be doing
mushy.
5, bro. Four to five.
You mean 5 with like the packaged one or the cup ones?
Package.
Yeah, with the microwave. Package, with the packaged one, definitely 5 minutes.
Yeah.
But with the cup ones,
what you doing? 3?
No, it's
bro,
4.
I'm doing like 4.
You put the
bro, 1 minute.
I'm doing 100% like 4.
Listen, 1 minute listen, difference, bro. It's a big listen. Difference.
And the microwave,
bro, it's
it
just going to be hot, bro. I'm just making sure my stuff not raw.
What you mean raw?
It ain't raw at 4 minutes.
Bro.
Your stuff just softer than ours. I like mine with
a little texture.
I don't want it melting
bro.
In my mouth.
Your shit
bro, it's
do
not
be
finna
raw.
Be melting.
Your
five
shit
minutes.
Do be raw at 4 minutes, bro.
Yeah, bro, your
I'm in
stuff
the dorms
not getting
with
cooked.
It. Nigga, I'm in the dorms with it right now, bro. Like, I'll be making ramen with the package and nigga, I'll be paying that shit 4 minutes. My noodles be hard, bro.
We no, got them, bro.
We don't got them. You spin them.
Real.
We got them, bro.
Look, I was just making noodles, bro.
Because what do you do after you cook it? You have to let it sit. You let it sit
nigga,
for about a minute.
You can't let it sit for too long.
I don't let my noodles sit.
You don't let them sit.
No, but I pour the water out, and then I put my seasoning in there, and then mix it in there.
I let it sit in the water.
How am I supposed to tell you how much water I leave?
Don't let them sit. They going to get soggy.
I mean, I don't leave a lot of water.
No, bro. You let them sit. That's water.
Hold on. Who are we talking over each other? How much water do you leave in your noodles?
Not a lot.
What's not a lot?
How am I supposed to?
If you had a bowl, how much water did you leave in your
bro,
noodles?
Bro, how am I supposed to show
Kobe,
you that?
Hand me that water bottle.
Bro, this is not going to help me. This is not going to help me.
How much water is you putting this in your noodles?
No, I'm putting more in there to cook them.
More?
To cook them, yes.
No, I'm talking about you poured water
out.
You definitely need more. What the fool? That's nothing.
But I don't know how much that is in a bowl, bro. I can't tell you that's in a water bottle.
Let me see it. Turn it sideways.
Bro, that's a decent amount of water, bro. That's enough.
Too much.
This thing got a lot of water.
How much noodles you got, though?
That's enough water.
It's a package of noodles.
This thing got a lot, bro.
That
look
like a lot
lie.
Of water. This thing got a lot of water for my noodles.
But I like a little juice after I'm done, though.
Bro.
I'm not slurping.
You slurping juice, bro.
Little juice
no,
to slurp.
Bro. That's too much sodium. That's too much sodium in that.
Bro.
Now you're healthy.
Nah, but I'm saying, you know what sodium is in that packet at the end, bro? I mean, it really mess your heart up, fool.
I ain't drinking the juice.
You taste it, bro. That mug is crazy strong, bro. Too salty, fool.
You said the sodium level's too high?
Sodium level's crazy in that. Like, that's one thing my pops used to tell me growing was like, don't drink the juice at the end. It's like low-key really bad for you. Like,
what that do to you, the sodium?
High cholesterol.
High cholesterol.
Yeah.
Heart attacks.
Yep.
All right. Yeah. Dasani or Ice Mountain?
Ice Mountain.
Ice Mountain.
Ice Mountain, bro. Dasani sucks, man.
Mm. Is this the debate?
This is the debate, bro. I'm not gonna lie.
This man is trifling.
Bro, Ice Mountain is shit, bro. Like,
what?
Ice Dasani? Mountain is ass.
Dasani?
Bro, Ice Mountain is ass, bro.
Dasani has a flavor.
Dasani is also ass.
Dasani has a taste to it, bro. I but don't
Ice
like.
Mountain got like that. Ice Mountain is just too spring water. Like, Ice Mountain tastes like you going, like you in the mountains type shit. And then you just drink it like fresh out the fucking waterfall, bro. Like, that shit nasty, bro. Like, Ice Mountain, not it. I mean, Dasani, not it too. But shit, I'm going Dasani over Ice Mountain, bro.
What's your go-to
Ice
water,
then? Terrible.
What's your go-to water?
Shit, nigga, like, just give me some great value shit, bro. Like, nigga. All of
bro. Trifling,
bro. Nigga,
is Pure Life good water? Pure Life.
Yeah, like Nestle, bro. That's
shit.
That's gas.
Yeah, that's what I be drinking.
You know, they only just Nestle and Ice Mountain, 1 and 2
for sure. Yeah.
What about Fiji though?
Fiji is just overpriced. But yeah. It's good. I mean, it's good. It's straight good. Water though. Yeah.
I feel
it's
like
good.
It's that bougie water.
Yeah, it's bougie.
But smart I like water. Smart water or Fiji.
I like smart water. I'd rather drink.
I never
smart
had smart
water.
Smart water over Fiji.
Wow. You gotta get you some.
That's crazy, the marketing that behind just putting smart over water, and all of a sudden it's just like you could charge $7 for a bottle.
I feel like it's the bottles too. Like the bottles, I like the bottles they be in. They be mouthpiece and stuff.
They be cool. Pitting like, I mean, like these are just waters found like just different places on the earth type shit.
But we don't even value your opinion anymore.
They just slap a label on shit. Well, you should.
He said
though.
Dasani.
Nigga, Ice Mountain is ass, nigga. Like, I'm taking this. I don't care. I'm taking Dasani over Ice Mountain.
All right.
That's wild. Some shit.
That's wild.
Panda or Wendy's?
Wendy's.
Panda.
Wendy's for sure.
I'm going Wendy's for.
You're taking Panda Express.
Panda Express.
What are we talking about?
What are we talking about? Panda Express over Wendy's.
Wait,
is
Wendy's crazy. Nuggets?
That's criminal.
Anything Wendy's.
Right, you talking about the nuggets.
Like, there's in general.
Bro, I feel like all Wendy's has is nuggets, though.
No, they don't.
Hold on, listen. So you would rather. You would rather have Wendy's closed down forever and keep Panda open, bro? That's what you're telling me?
Never.
For one, Wendy's fries are trash.
Dude.
Their fries are good,
bro. You're tripping.
Their fries used to suck.
Their fries are great now.
They're great now.
They changed the barbecue sauce recipe.
No, they didn't.
Yes, they did. Yes, they did.
It's still good. Tasty sweet.
They changed
it's still
it.
Nice sweet and tangy. I'm still nice, sweet, and good.
It's good, bro. You're tripping.
But you eat Famous Days, bro. Don't tell me.
Get the fuck out of those.
Wait, bro. What are you doing Famous Days?
Wait, I have Famous Days and like, nigga, I don't know how long.
Sure,
fuck out of here.
We was talking in the car earlier, bro. If you eating Golden Corral at 20 something, you trifling, bro.
Golden Corral.
Well, that's all you can afford.
But I'm still going Panda.
Dude, you're crazy.
You saying that, Wendy's gone, but and then you taking Panda?
Yeah,
that is a hot take, bro.
What do you eat from Panda?
Nobody's agreeing with that, bro.
What is your Panda meal?
Absolutely
if
nobody.
If you do a poll, nobody's agreeing with that.
What's your Panda meal? What's your go-to Panda?
I'm going to Panda. I'm getting a bigger plate.
Okay.
So that's two entrees plus an extra entree.
I know.
And you got the side.
We know what it is.
You see? I'm getting triple orange.
Triple orange?
That's OD.
It's already disgusting.
Your plate is already foul. Triple orange.
That's so OD.
No, bro. I always ask, is the orange chicken? I always ask, is the orange chicken fresh?
Okay, they're not making a new batch for you, bro.
They're gonna say yes regardless, bro.
Hey, bro.
You're fresh or not, you getting this orange chicken.
You see how they had to cook the orange chicken?
Yeah, bro. You're tweaking.
It's not individual nuggets. They gotta maybe cooking full batches, bro.
They'll look at your ass so stupid. They'll be like, bro, who the fuck you think you is?
He thought he was the president rolling his head, bro.
Asking for a fresh batch and some orange chicken. Fuck out of here.
Orange chicken fresh, bro. Nah.
Shorty, I swear, sometimes they be telling me, yes, I'm getting the bomb of the batch. Like, orange chicken stale. Oh bro, but if they tell me it's not fresh, I drive off, bro. I'm going to a different spot.
No,
I'm going to a different spot, bro.
I don't got to worry about that with Wendy's.
No, I agree.
No. Wendy's, bro. Only thing Wendy's has good is they open late. That's all the good.
Bro, stop disrespecting the
Nuggets too. Besides Nuggets, you can burger
Wendy's
from Wendy's.
Breakfast.
Bro, Panda don't got no desserts, bro.
Right, Wendy's has
Wendy's got the
Frosties. They got fortune cookies.
Oh, nobody eating them fortune cookies, bro.
This is crazy.
Nigga said fortune.
Wendy's has chili.
They have chili and I tried it and it's actually good.
It's talking about chili.
Why would you even mention that?
Listen,
why would you mention that?
That's a bad mention, bro.
It's not a bad mention.
You're down bad.
The reason why I'm mentioning it is to show you that they diverse. And that the chili, I tried the chili. It's actually pretty freaking good, bro.
Still getting chili, bro. Are we valuing this man's opinion?
Yeah, we are. Cause I had their French toast too. Delicious.
Nah, Wendy's breakfast is good. I had Wendy's bacon. What was it?
Shorty, I'm crying.
Like bacon, egg, and cheese breakfast. Yeah. It with orange juice.
Sheesh.
Hit. Hash brown too.
Type shit.
Decent.
Panda Dog even got breakfast, bro.
I'm saying, you eating the same thing?
You gonna eat that triple bigger plate, triple orange chicken?
Shorty, you eat triple orange. Shorty, leftover panda be hitting in the morning.
I got a question. This is
leftover panda is terrible.
Hey, this is gonna solve it all. If you could only eat everything from Wendy's forever or everything from Panda forever, what are you choosing?
Please make the right decision.
Like, bro, you choose Panda, you're absurd. I'm sorry.
Yeah, your opinion doesn't matter.
Chow mein rice.
That would be foul if every you chose that shit.
What are you getting from Wendy's every day? A burger?
I could switch up burger. I can go.
Oh, wait. We're talking about.
You can get
only
a salad from the healthy.
Are we talking about
salad, mac and cheese? Listen.
I can go mac and cheese.
We talking about only all of Panda's menu or then all of Wendy's?
All of Panda, all
okay,
of Wendy's.
I'll go Wendy's.
Done.
But.
There it is.
Done.
But.
Done.
But what?
But what?
I'm still going Panda though.
Nigga, don't nobody want that fucking like sweet ass
walnut shrimp,
sesame seed.
Oh, yeah, shit,
we don't want that shit.
We
every
got
day.
Broccoli at Panda. We got healthy.
Boy, that broccoli ass.
Yeah. Nobody want that broccoli.
Shorty, that's why Wendy's be having one person work there, bro. It'd be like two people in the whole Wendy's running.
Well,
that
don't got nothing to do with the food, bro.
Yes, it do.
And my food gonna still be good.
My
food gonna still be good.
Give me a little frosty. All
right, listen.
$5 biggie bag.
Give me a cookie or something.
Wingstop or Buffalo?
Wingstop. What the heck?
Fuck.
Wingstop.
The heck?
All the way.
Wingstop.
What are you saying?
Defensive.
Okay. We good then.
Boneless or bone-in?
Bone-in.
Kobe's a boneless guy. I'm looking at him.
Boneless.
He's crying. I'm going bone-in from Wingstop, but I'm going boneless from Buffalo.
I agree.
That's a good take.
Good take.
That's an amazing take.
I agree with that.
I'm going boneless Wingstop.
Bone-in
Wingstop. Oh, yeah. Boneless Buffalo.
Yes.
Yeah.
W take.
Thank you.
Hey, honey barbecue from Buffalo Wild Wings?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm not a barbecue chicken type of dude.
You don't like honey barbecue?
He's a mild
like Buffalo type of dude.
Okay. What you getting from what's your Buffalo Wild Wings?
Yeah, garlic parm. He's a garlic parm.
Fuck.
No, he not, bro. He's not no garlic parm.
Give me some Buffalo. Give me Buffalo with some ranch. That's all I need, bro.
Buffalo. Okay.
Buffalo with ranch.
What about Wingstop? What are we talking about at Wingstop?
Wingstop, give me some lemon pepper.
Lemon pepper.
Lemon pepper.
Lemon pepper.
Hey, Louisiana rub.
I can do that.
I can do that too.
But I'm picking lemon pepper.
Yeah, for sure.
Bro, but that chicken sandwich from Wingstop,
it's good.
Great.
Shit hit.
Better than Popeyes?
Oh, I forgot to tell y'all.
I think so.
My last Wingstop chicken sandwich was foul.
Really?
Bit into it, it crunched. Had to spit it out. I had to eat around it, foe. It was so foul,
like,
bro.
The edges was crispy too.
They
crispy.
Had the loin.
No,
it
was like it
sandwich.
Was like fatty in it. It was just some like crunchiness. You know, you just got to spit some out.
Yeah.
And you just got to throw the whole meal away. It was one of them. I didn't even save the fries, bro. I threw the ranch away too.
Ooh.
I was so upset. It was so nasty. I waited so long for that meal. I crunched to it. Spit it. I was like, all right, let me see. Took another bite. I had to spit the second one, bro. I just boom.
He was pissed.
I just rolled up the bag, tossed it in the trash.
That's different anger right there.
I threw the fries out too. That's tough.
Oh, God. Fries, I was my was turned off by the whole meal. Bro. I ain't gonna lie.
McDonald's or Wendy's?
Wendy's, yeah.
McDonald's is foul, bro.
McDonald's is foul, bro. I'm not getting.
It's not foul, bro.
I ain't gonna lie. Deuce came in with the McDonald's sandwich, bro. I was just thinking, like, I don't ever eat McDonald's no more.
Bro,
that's all I was thinking in my head.
All McDonald's has is breakfast, bro. Their lunch and dinner, bro, has fell off since COVID started, bro. The McChickens don't even taste the same.
Way before COVID.
Bro, the McChickens don't even taste the same.
Yeah, because we know all he used to eat was McChickens.
I don't even eat McDonald's no more.
You don't agree?
Nah.
What do you eat from? How? When's the last time you had McDonald's?
Not too long ago. I'd say more than about 2 weeks. More than 2 weeks. But
what you get?
My go-to is usually a quarter pounder or a double quarter pounder.
You eating burgers from McDonald's?
Wow.
Yeah, bro. that, with bro, the fries.
That's criminal.
I'm sorry.
That's criminal.
Hey, bro.
That's
criminal.
Can I defend myself? Can I defend myself? I feel like, bro, McDonald's isn't as bad as people make it seem, as long as you're not eating it all the time, bro. That's just me, though.
When I eat McDonald's, it just tastes so processed. It don't taste like, when I bite into a Chick-fil-A sandwich or a Wendy's, it tastes real.
Bro, you comparing McDonald's and Chick-fil-A, bro.
But Wendy's, Wendy's. Okay, Wendy's, bro.
Wendy's is better. Yeah.
I eat it. It's quality, bro. I go to McDonald's. I'm eating just, I feel like I'm eating just processed like fries? Plastic.
McDonald's fries bad too.
Their fries fell off. Bro. They're not even hitting how they used to.
Damn. Only when they're fresh, bro.
Yeah. It's, they hitting, but
the
they not.
The chances you getting fresh McDonald's fries is like 1 out of 10.
Hash browns?
Yes.
Yeah, hash browns? I can eat the hash browns.
You don't like the hash browns? Great.
I don't even get them.
What about they hot cakes, fool?
Hot cakes.
Yeah. Hot cakes is gas. Yeah, yeah. I haven't had them in a long time. But
bro, sometimes I'll be getting them, bro. It's like they not cooked, microwaved all the way up. I'll be getting a little frostbite on the ends. I'm like, bro, throw a whole pancakes off, bro. You'd be pissed, bro. Okay, let's say this.
Oh, no.
This next one's going to be controversial.
Okay.
Let's hear it, bro.
Little Caesars? Or Beggars, or Little Caesars, or Domino's.
Domino's. What the heck?
Yeah, that's no question.
Domino's. No question. Domino's pizza is so much better.
I like Domino's, but here I'm going Caesars.
Why?
Price. Yeah.
That's it.
You can get a whole pizza. It's not $5.90. It's not $5 no more. Inflation. We were looking about $7 right now, but bro, a fresh Little Caesars pizza, bro. When it's cooked right, bro, it's competing with whoever, bro.
So it's not price over quality.
Hell no,
price yo, over you're quality? Tripping, bro.
Because Domino's pizza is not bad, bro,
and it's not that expensive.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You right, but
it's like a few dollars.
Domino's
difference.
Pizza don't even be having the garlic crust no more. Like they cut back on the garlic.
I don't get the garlic crust, but so
you can buy some garlic.
You can thin crust.
No, like the regular crust. I'm not a crust guy.
Regular
so.
Crust is
you
don't garlic crust,
you just
it?
Eat the sauce, no?
Yeah, I just be eating a pizza. Sometimes I throw the crust off to the side. I might dip the ranch or something.
It all depends on my mood. Sometimes
I'm a crust guy.
If the crust is hidden, I'm gonna munch down on the crust. But if it's not, that crust being tossed.
Do y'all like home run in?
No.
Fuck
I do.
No.
I do.
That no. shit's terrible.
What's the problem
like
with home run in?
That's what I'm saying. Bro, people really hate home run
sauce,
in.
What's wrong bro. With that?
Like sauce is, yes. Thank you.
Bro.
Thank you.
The sauce is ass. The sauce is ass. The pizza sucks. And just what's, fuck that place.
I don't understand it, bro.
Bro. You're wild.
Dang, bro. Dude, I don't understand bro. The hate.
Home run in is like bottom of the barrel.
I don't understand why y'all bottom, feel that way.
I'm going Little Caesars over
That's
too far.
No, I'm
Little
taking Little
Caesars over a home run in.
1,000%.
Dinner style pizza.
1,000%.
Dude, that is
and
so crazy to me,
I'm not
bapping.
Little Caesars?
That's not even a freaking question, dude.
Home run
no
in
way.
So if we catering for an event, were you telling me you going to get Little Caesars over a home run in to cater?
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah.
I feel like y'all only say that because of price.
Nah, don't nobody want no home run in.
Bro, what is the problem with home run in?
That shit is so ass. Like, damn. They be putting too much sauce on their pizza. Like, the sauce,
I like sauce on my pizza, though, bro.
Too much, though. Like, it get to a point, especially when the sauce ain't that good.
It's bro, like, look, y'all hyping Little Caesars like it's really that good.
I'm not even
Little
hyping Little
Caesars.
Caesars
tastes like cardboard, for real.
Like, for real. Like, what?
That's like cardboard. It tastes like cardboard.
Little Caesars is trash.
Better than home run in.
Definitely not.
No, not
I stand on that.
Not
that
a
is,
chance.
That is
bro.
An L take. Walgreens or CVS? Oh, Kobe, you should say something, Kobe?
Walgreens. Hey, look, if you just air fry it, bro, I kid you not, bro, air frying a Little Caesars pizza gonna be way better than air frying some fucking leftover home run in bullshit.
Gap.
Facts.
Gap.
Facts.
Okay, Walgreens or CVS? I'm going Walgreens. I'm a little biased.
I'm Walgreens too.
Yeah, Walgreens.
Well, if you say CVS, you probably just weird.
I don't understand, like, what's the big difference between them, though? What is the big difference?
There is none to me.
CVS
is
just
like, a preference, I guess.
It's just like, I don't know.
CVS's business model is move anywhere Walgreens is at. I actually learned this.
Bro, they be around. Bro, it's always Walgreens and CVS.
That's what they do. They Walgreens, they put themselves on high business corners, and CVS will just follow them. And just be right across the street. Literally, I'm so serious. That's what they do. Like, that's what CVS
Walgreens
model
gonna always get more go always get more business though. I think
I feel 100%. Like Walgreens more like the big bro.
Yeah, Walgreens
more. It's like big, more bro. Like the elder to CVS.
What's yeah. y'all? What's y'all favorite meal? Like, what's y'all go to meal? Home cooked. Mm. Y'all OG could snap on something. Y'all could snap on something. What y'all? What's y'all?
My OG making it.
Yeah. I'm going fried chicken, mozzarella, some garlic knots, a little garlic bread, eat my bread, and some like either some like cold water or some like a little Oberweiss lemonade.
Oberweiss lemonade. So
that was stupid for specific.
Bro. Oh, that Oberweiss lemonade.
Never
hit.
Had it before.
I have. This is amazing.
Really?
Yes.
Nigga, Chipotle lemonade hit. Let's talk about it.
I'm not a Chipotle guy. I don't eat Chipotle.
Really?
No, that's insane.
Dang, bro. Have you had it before?
Not eating
right?
Chipotle automatically you makes never, me snatch your headphone
you've
off.
You never had Chipotle.
Bro, is Chipotle bro. Really like that, though?
Yes.
It's pretty good. Yeah,
it is like that.
You're Chipotle tweaking. Or Chick-fil-A?
That's not a question. It's Chick-fil-A.
Yeah. Okay, then.
Chick-fil-A. No, that's not even comparable. You can't compare the two. They're not one's like fast food. Other one is more like
fried
you know,
food.
Healthy.
Oh, Chipotle is fast food.
But it's healthy fast food. That's kind of like
Chipotle,
their premise.
Chipotle is like bowls and burritos.
Bowls
that's,
hell yeah.
You can't compare that to Chick-fil-A, bro. <Guac. laughs>
So can you compare Chipotle to Panda?
Yes.
I think they're in the same category.
I guess.
They're in the same category,
I'm going
but
Panda. Chipotle is better.
I'm going Chipotle all
as well.
Day.
Like, after that bad Panda experience I had, bro, I'm done defending that place, bro. I'm done defending that fucking place.
Let that Panda experience go.
Nah, bro.
No,
I would never let
you
that
gotta,
go.
When you have a bad experience, you know how to turn you off.
I would never let that go.
It take you months to get back into the flow.
I threw my whole plate away.
Hey, Marty, you know, Brett, he don't mess with Canes because he had food poisoning from Canes.
Oh, wow.
Like, he don't mess with Canes no more at all. It's one of those. I feel like, yeah, one experience like that'll mess you up for real.
Yeah, bro, when you on the toilet praying to God, like, man, Canes, God, I would never eat this again. Like, bro, y'all ever had y'all stomach was hurting so bad? Like, you in there praying, like, God, like, yeah. I will never do this again. Like,
so you got the runs.
The runs, bro. You be dying, boy.
Canes is overrated too.
Nah,
I wouldn't say it's overrated.
It is.
It's not overrated, bro. It's not,
bro.
It's a little overrated, just a little bit.
Bro, I don't think so.
Just a little bit.
Canes and Wingstop.
I think I like is I like oh Canes and Wingstop. What?
Wingstop.
Yeah, I go Wingstop.
But no, I'm saying like I think what makes Canes amazing is their business model is just fire, bro. Like they have. They have you know what you're going to
they
Canes
have four
for.
Items on them.
They have four that's all they items. And that's all, and that's all they need because when you're in the mood for some tenders, you know where to go. You know where to go. You get the Caniac.
Get the Caniac.
You get the box.
I'll be getting the Caniac every time.
Trey,
you a fat ass.
Trey, you a fat ass.
What's the Caniac?
I only got box, bro.
It's six tenders.
The box is where you cap it off.
Like fries.
You cap it off at the box.
Wait.
You get the Caniac. You gritty.
Give me the tiers, bro. What do you start off with?
Okay,
the bottom?
So look, there's
the
kids, a kitty. Man. There's a kitty one, right?
How many
you get
is
two
that?
Tenders.
Two tenders. Man, what's the box?
Then you get the three finger combo. That's three. You get the box. That's four. That's where you cap it, bro. The Caniac, you get six tenders. Six. Why the fuck do you need six tenders?
My bad, bro. Then I be switching the coleslaw out with the extra bread. I be getting two breads.
Hell yeah,
six tenders.
Yeah,
you gotta do that. That's mandatory.
That's law. That's law.
Law for sure. Yeah.
Hey, Kobe put me on with something real cool though. So you take your cane sauce,
bro.
You ask for some hot sauce packets, which is Louisiana, and you pour like one or two of them in the cane sauce, and you mix it. It becomes like a hotter cane sauce, and it's gas.
It should gas.
It
you pour the whole packet in there.
Whole packet. It's not a lot. It's not a lot. Trust me, like because the cane thing is this big.
It don't even got to be the whole pack. It don't got to
be.
Whole pack,
I do the whole packet. I want mine kind of spicy, but it still don't even be that hot. It just be like. It upgrade the flavor.
It
bro.
Do.
It
that
do.
Shit good. It's I feel hard. You. I feel you.
It I'll make the flavor it. Taste better.
That's hard.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Try that out one day for sure.
Dairy Queen or Oberweiss?
I'm a Dairy
I'm
Queen.
A Dairy. I'm taking Dairy.
I'm yeah, taking a Blizzard sure. any day. A
Oreo
Blizzard.
Blizzard. Oreo Blizzard. Yeah.
I'm taking Dairy.
I'm talking
Queen.
A chocolate brownie
big,
Blizzard.
Big Dairy Queen.
100% Dairy Queen.
Overwise is mid. I don't care.
Nah, it's not mid. It's not mid.
It's not mid.
It's Overwise is high good. Quality. It's just too expensive, bro.
Overwise yeah, is good.
You gonna Overwise walk out of good. You walking out of Overwise cone. Spending yeah. $20 on some ice cream.
That's yeah. what I'm saying.
Overwise
bro.
Slander is not tolerated. That's
I'm sorry.
Good,
that's too
bro.
Far.
Yeah. Other than their lemonade.
Yeah.
Nah, what, bro, you tripping. Bro? You
tripping. Other than the lemonade, that's not even what they really
what are you
known
even talking
for.
About? Hey, what you?
Bro, you might be the only nigga on this earth who talk about Overwise lemonade. don't nobody give a fuck about that.
I mean, it's good. I ain't gonna hold you, yeah. but I'm not going to buy Overwise lemonade. It's too expensive for.
That's
but
what
it
we
tastes,
get at the crib.
It don't be Overwise enough. Lemonade. It don't be enough in that thing, bro. That thing gonna run out quick.
But you know what you can do? You can once it's empty, you can turn them back in and get money.
Yeah, I heard
Wait,
that.
What?
I heard
you
that.
What?
You can do turn, you can turn those back in and get money.
The carton.
Yeah.
And get how much? Like a dollar?
I think like $2-3 each. That's like $6. You might get like half.
Oh, wow. That's like half the price of the. Yeah. Oh, that's decent, okay.
Oh, bro.
That's a little cool.
Yeah. Get a yeah. little money back. Clay buries 12 triples. Clay Thompson hit 12 threes.
Damn. 12?
42 points.
Better
than, oh, damn. My gosh. What the heck, bro?
Better than the Lakers.
He on some my career okay. shit.
Here we go, bro.
I got a question for y'all.
Here we go. LeBron on mic?
Huh?
No, go ahead.
I was finna ask y'all, do y'all believe in the Illuminati?
Well, I don't know enough about it to say what I'm like, give an answer about that.
No comment.
No comment.
Nah. I think that there's like, I don't think there's like really like an essence of it. Like even if they do try to make like Illuminati groups, I don't think there's like any type of higher type power that they really like getting shit from. I don't think they selling their souls or nothing like that. I still think that shit cap. Even though they be doing some weird ass shit in the industry, I don't think that shit holds any actual weight though. Like I feel like nigga, you could say you sold your soul, but you could just say you sold your soul and you ain't fucking sell your soul. Like, you feel what I'm saying? Like, how do you really sell your soul for real? Like, you feel what I'm saying?
It's just a phrase.
It's a phrase, but like,
it's like giving your life to this no matter what. You know what I'm saying?
Type shit.
So like, y'all like know a lot about that stuff? Like, y'all researched it or like, how do y'all know about that? Or y'all don't want to talk about
it? I mean, the Illuminati was a group that was like, I was back like a while ago, you feel what I'm saying? Like 70s, like before that, just early type shit, the Illuminati was around. So I don't know what the fuck this new shit about. Like, I don't know, like with all these celebrities and shit, because that wasn't even like what the Illuminati originally was, like earlier, you feel what I'm saying?
True.
Yeah, it's probably, I don't think it's like, it's probably, I don't think whatever, the, I don't think it's actually there's an Illuminati. It's probably not an Illuminati. But there's definitely obviously higher social groups at the top, let's say the food chain for per se, you know what I'm saying? When it comes to wealth, there's definitely organized groups that are controlling different things, 100%. And that's clear, you feel me? Like, you can see that throughout all business, you know what I'm saying? It's few businesses that control all the businesses in the world. If you really look at like who controls what, it's very few businesses that control the major brands that we consume on a day-to-day basis when it comes to everything.
Right.
It's very few businesses that have majority stakes and majority of these companies that are controlling what narrative is being pushed. You feel me? But, yeah, I mean, I don't know if there's Illuminati or not, but they definitely try to act like there is, for sure. Like, they definitely try to act like it, you know what I'm saying? Like, Rihanna came out at the Super Bowl, first thing she did, if you actually pay attention, was she threw up the triangle, first thing. Adele performed of her performance, Grammys, everything was behind, was on triangles, you feel me? Like, the Illuminati, their sanctuary is supposed to be a checkerboard. If you pay attention enough, a lot of these performances be on checkerboards, you feel me? Like, Beyonce's, her recent photo on Instagram, it's like half her dress is checkerboard for a reason, you know what I'm saying? It's like, it's pretty clear. It's a lot of stuff that they do. I don't know, it's definitely some type of agenda being pushed. I won't call it Illuminati, but whatever it is, There's some agreements with people that have wealth of like, hey, we give you this money, status, and wealth in exchange for your loyalty to us. You know what I'm saying? If you try to go against us, it's gonna be some problems. You look at Kanye. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think it's somebody like Kanye. Like,
The reason Kanye gets blackballed is because he won't let them control him. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, it's certain narratives that I don't agree with Kanye say, but it's certain things like Kanye got blackballed out of Adidas. Kanye got blackballed out of these a lot of these brands, and it's like, man, bro, we know what's going on, bro.
A lot of this industry shit is weird. Like, motherfuckers be doing some weird ass, like, demonic shit. Yeah, you heard about that Bella Thorne shit?
What happened?
Bella Thorne?
So,
we get into conspiracies now.
No, this ain't a conspiracy. This is real shit. So, you remember Wo Vicky? Like, that one girl who tried to act black and shit? Yeah. So, she went up to a party at Bella Thorne shit. And to get in, you had to, like, cut yourself. And then, like, pitch your blood in, like, this little, like, silver container thing. And that's how, like, you got in to the party. Like, you had to, like, give them your blood, like, some weird shit. So, like, Vicky was just like, nah, like, fuck that. Like, we turn around. That shit, like, weird shit like that. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I feel like that's some industry just, like, just weird.
That's
just
hella weird, bro.
Feel what I'm saying? Like, I ain't rocking with that.
I ain't never heard about that.
Oh, yeah, bro. That shit wild. Heck, bro? Oh, yeah.
Hey. Rick Ross or DJ Khaled?
Music making or producing
songs? I think I'm going Rick Ross.
DJ Khaled.
DJ Khaled as a producer.
We didn't care about DJ Khaled actually rapping, but
DJ Khaled has way too many bangers.
Yeah, bro, DJ Rick Khaled Ross got bangers too, though, bro.
He do.
That's hard. That's a hard one.
It is.
I'm going DJ Khaled though.
Yeah,
but it's a close toss up
for sure. You going Khaled?
Yeah, DJ.
Yeah,
DJ's that guy.
Rick Ross worked on a lot of songs that we don't know he's worked on though.
That's true.
If you hear Maybach Music, ain't that Rick Ross? No, I'm tripping.
Yeah, that's Rick Ross, I think, right?
Yeah,
something like that.
I'm still going DJ Khaled, bro,
for sure.
You got a whole lot. Rick Ross be doing some weird stuff.
Yeah,
we just going Khaled do too. Khaled be doing some weird stuff too.
We gonna ignore that Rick Ross line. Back in like 2014 on that
Molly and her champagne.
Oh yeah,
she didn't even know it. Come on, bro, we know Gross was what he was on.
I took home and enjoyed that. She didn't even know.
That's
it.
A crazy bar, dude.
Niggas ain't give a fuck.
Big hefty.
Niggas ain't give one fuck though. And like, even when people notice it, like, they just make memes about it. Then just walk over it. No one really care.
He low key never. Did he ever address that lyric? Like,
I don't think he ever addressed it. I don't think he give a fuck. I don't think he care enough to address that shit.
He's still making money off that song.
Hell yeah, to this day.
Yeah, that's a crazy bar, bro. He literally fed himself out about that.
Though, like, dead ass.
On some weird. Imagine him doing that, like, in this era of time.
Hell no. They'll cancel Rick.
Cancel real quick.
Rick would be done for.
That nigga would be done.
That's wild.
Back then, niggas just ain't used to care like that, though.
Just talking.
People wasn't sensitive as they are now.
It wasn't as sensitive, yeah.
Yeah.
That's still foul, though.
I was just going to ask how y'all feel about the whole cancel culture thing. How y'all feel about that? Like, this new era, like,
just you can't be human.
So sensitive.
You can't be human.
Not sensitive, but people being sensitive to certain things that are said. How y'all feel about that back when we was younger and, like, things wasn't the same as it is now?
Well, you can't say nothing nowadays. Like, you can't be human. You can't make a mistake. Comedians can't be comedians. Like, the whole point of being comedians is they joked about stuff that we all was feeling uncomfortable about.
Exactly.
You say stuff now, bro, they ready to take your head off. You cancel your whole tour.
Yeah. They're trying to cancel Dave Chappelle.
What Dave Chappelle does. Though. That's what made him good, because he talked about stuff that we were uncomfortable talking about. Yeah. Now, bro, I ain't gonna lie. Bro, a lot of that happened to do with that LGBTQ community too, bro.
Yeah,
true.
I have nothing wrong with nobody for you enjoying what you want or, like, whatever you want to do, but just don't be, bro, like, y'all be trying to control everything nowadays.
So, like, I'm saying, bro, like, you can make, motherfuckers make jokes about everything else. You feel what I'm saying? Everything else. Every race get joked on, black people, you feel me, white people, Asian people, and then motherfuckers say one thing about LGBTQ is outrage. Then again, like, that was a rare Netflix W, though. Like, they said they was trying to fucking boycott Dave Chappelle comedy shit. Netflix said, fuck that. We keeping that shit up. We making our money off that shit. They ain't care, bro. Mm.
Yeah.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
I don't know, man.
Cancel culture sucks, man.
Yeah, I just think, yeah, it sucks, bro. I don't know.
It's foul, bro. I just want to know, like, who's the actual people commenting? Like who's the, who are the commenting people?
How did it start, bro?
I don't even know, bro.
Like, when did it start? How did it start? Why did
Twitter,
it start?
Bro.
You know
Twitter, bro.
Twitter. You know what Twitter say? It was Queen Naija's fault. Bro, Twitter, bro. Twitter hates Queen Naija.
Wow. Yeah, Twitter does say, bro.
Every time I see somebody tweet, like, it was Queen Naija.
It was Queen Naija.
Or they be like, you know, Brother Nature.
They hate Brother Nature.
Y'all remember him.
They hate him on Twitter. We don't forget. We won't forget.
Every time Brother Nature posts, they be like, do you think we forgot?
Think we forgot? You're like, bro, are you serious?
They be like, we didn't forget. They be like, bro, that man, they, bro, I bet you if I go on his Instagram right now, the first thing you gonna say is,
we didn't forget.
We didn't forget. Every time he posts a picture, I go and look at the comments, he be like, we didn't forget.
Hey, guess what's going on? Hey, tomorrow at 6, Delta probate.
Yeah, it's confirmed.
Confirmed.
Dang.
I think that's where we at tomorrow.
For sure.
That's the move.
Gotta check it out. Especially since they've been gone, too.
Yeah, I'm down for that. A little Delta probate, man.
What's the word? What's the word tomorrow, though? Y'all, what y'all want to do?
We definitely need to do something, bro. We got podcast at 3.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to just watch that one.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm going to say, like, over there, so.
Oh, bro.
I mean, I might hop in it just because I don't know,
bro.
Make my homies come.
I went to go see. Somebody said, I low key forgot. Dude said, we haven't forgotten.
Why they don't mess with Queen? What happened with Queen, though?
Queen said some colorist stuff or something like that. Yeah. Ever since then, they
be on her.
She
said
something like light skins are better. So I think she said something. I don't know what it was, but she's canceling her.
Dang, that's wild.
But
you can't say nothing out there.
Not at all, bro. Especially about color. Yeah. Like light skin, dark
anything,
skin. Like,
bro.
You can't say
anything.
That, bro. Nah, it's cooked.
People just so sensitive, bro.
It's cooked now.
Y'all really think light skinned girls be getting praised more?
100%.
In certain shit.
1000%.
For sure.
I'm not gonna comment.
I don't know.
Bro, I thought, bro,
I'm gonna leave that up to the world, bro.
Yeah, I don't think so. I'm not gonna comment on that.
I think so. I think people favor light skins. But it comes from, it's history behind that. You know what I'm saying? History behind the light skinned slaves being a house slave while the darker slaves were out in the field. They're more favorable in the eyes of the white man or the white woman. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it comes from hundreds and hundreds of years ingrained into us that colorism happens. You feel me? That turns us against each other. You feel me? Like, if you're a lighter color, you're more favorable. That's what it is in the eyes of society, it seems like. If you're a dark color, people you get treated differently because of that. You know what I'm saying? The darker you are, you get treated worse, it seems like. That's my take on that. And even within our own communities, like, there's that, bro, for sure. Like,
yeah, I feel that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think this was a great pod.
Yeah. We went crazy.
Good times, bro.
For sure.
This was a late night bloopers.
This nigga getting tired, bro. I see him, bro.
He's yawning, folks.
I'll say he been yawning the past 20 minutes.
I'm light skinned, man. You know? But, the train perspective, we out.
Yes, sir.